So these new developments not only brings back the grief, but the trauma of reliving what happened 2 years ago. Every news report, every time Abby and Libby's picture pops up on your timeline on Facebook, or every time the suspect's image is in a business window, these are considered trauma triggers, and everyone handles them differently.
The streets may be quiet in Delphi.
My heart jumped. It made me very nervous, yeah.
But inside, people are frustrated, anxious, and fearful.
Wherever you are, we're gonna get you. We're gonna find you.
Each piece of additional information,
we believe you are hiding in plain sight,
can add an additional sense of trauma.
Back to the moment that the news was first initially announced.
Heather Servati-Saib is a professor of counseling psychology at Purdue University. She says grief is multidimensional.
It's emotional, cognitive, it's physical, it's social, it's spiritual. It's all of those aspects. It's also very, very unique to each person.
Although unique, for many, this new sketch, audio and video released, could be difficult to process.
Some may experience it in a way where they do have emotions and they do want to talk about it with others in their life. Some may experience it in a way where they want to do something very physical, where they want to do something to make a difference and to help someone else.
Servati-Saib says for those dealing with PTSD, the images could bring on nightmares or flashbacks.
Avoidance of areas that would remind people of the situation.
The key, acknowledging how to cope and recognizing justice for Abby and Libby is what's important.
Really missing these two young girls and all they contributed to community.
There are several ways to reach out for PTSD or grief counseling. There are national hotlines. We've placed that information over on our website. Reporting in Delphi, Melissa Crash, back to you.
Important information, Melissa. Thank you. So once again, here's where we stand this evening. In the past 2 years, police have received more than 40,000 tips. They've looked at more than 1,100 people, but still no arrest in this case. So again, we're putting the word out this evening. If you know anything,